Let's do this. Sophia Amaral, Mark's resident chronon scientist. Well, she must know a lot of the same stuff Will did.
Stay sharp! He's here!
They don't make this easy.
He's trying.
no clear exit down here. May have to head upward. There's gotta be something I can use to get up there.
Chronon harvesting process canceled. Insufficient chronon particles detected. Please move harvester to designated yellow zone anomalous area.
No clear exit down here. May have to head upward. Elevator.
Jack, I found documents here about some kind of private gala Marnik is hosting tonight.
Tonight? After everything that's happened?
It has something to do with their future plans. Serene's delivering a speech, and the guest list has everybody from Monarch higher-ups to big-shot scientists to the mayor of Riverport, which raises the question... Why now?
I don't know, but I'm gonna find out. Okay. Getting closer, I think. Now, which way's the dry dock?
I got that briefcase we lifted from William Joyce's car. Laid out the contents in the trailer. You want me to go through?
No. Serene wants the first look. Till then, hands off.
Okay.
Hello,
okay.
Riverport.
Looks like the trailer has power now.
This is Teresa Sedmak, filling in for Bobby Radford. Bobby's taking a little break for health reasons. I'm sure you'll all join me in wishing him a speedy recovery. Just take all the time you need, Bobby. We've got your back. Now, not to get too serious. serious on you right out of the gate, but here's the latest on the awful tragedy down at Riverport University. The authorities are now looking for Jack Joyce, believed to be the mastermind behind the terrorist action at the university and personally responsible for several deaths. Details are still scarce, but it's believed Joyce's own brother, William Joyce, is among the dead. Little about Joyce is known yet, but given the actions of the activist group he was part of, it is now clear that allowing the anti-corporate protest to continue has backfired at a great human cost. Joyce's current whereabouts are unknown. Fortunately, security personnel from Monarch Solutions were on site and managed to intervene, saving countless lives. We'll keep you updated as this story develops. And now, some music.
Paul's men had taken the briefcase from Will's car, dumped the contents on the table. Will had said he needed something from his briefcase to stop the fracture. Wasn't much there but his phone and a key to the Bradbury swimming pool. Not the most obvious clues.
Jack, it's Beth. Monarch just got footage of your lady friend sniffing around some confidential Monarch files. Kind of a big no-no around here.
Amy, I gotta go back for her.
Don't. I'll pick her up. Where are you?
I'm on my way to Paul, the dry docks.
Serene's not the priority. I'm getting you out of there. I'll meet you at the dry docks. Channel 1 is the Monarch frequency. Use it to keep ahead of them. And Jack, don't do anything stupid.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. Amy, you okay out there? Shit. gate's locked. There's got to be another way to get through here.
Positions around ground zero.
Roger.
I recognized Will's workshop as soon as I saw the old billboard on top.
The area we refer to as Ground Zero.
It was clear that the workshop was at the center of the Monarch operation. I wanted to see what was in there, and it seemed to be the only way to the dry docks and Serene.
Got the word. Safeguard squad's checking out that explosion. Striker team is establishing a defensive perimeter around Ground Zero.
An entire Striker team? For one guy?
University incident got HQ wetting their pants. The kid's gonna get torn apart like a goddamn pinata.
Take cover!
Thank you.
more backup. Approaching! Gate's locked! Ah, screw it! I'm coming through!
Men to move through stutters. He knew the fracture would occur. Prepared for it.
Holy shit.
And yet he never tried to stop it.
Thank you.
what he did in that workshop? At Ground Zero?
No, never. He hid that part of his life from me. Nothing prepared me for the weirdness that was waiting there. And even that was just a prelude to the bad stuff that would follow in that same place later.
Absolutely no entry. But I'm pretty sure that's more of a guideline than a rule.
What the hell? What is this? What is this? That already happened. What the fuck?
Requested copper-clad niobium.
Well,
there's no words to describe it. Will was gone. He was all around me. This entire secret life he'd never talked about, everything he tried to protect me from, it surrounded me. A puzzle, trapped in broken time. We all thought he wasted his research grant, his career, obsessing over some failed experiment. That's what he led us to believe. What he built there, it never failed.
It works. It works.
My grant extended another year. Please, don't do this. Hello?
Thank you.
countermeasure. I hope to God this works.
Will. It's gone. I knew something went horribly wrong there, but it was scrambled. It was impossible to crack. Overwhelming. Every unanswered question I had was compounded by what I'd seen at that workshop. The events at the university were part of something much bigger. Something that had started 17 years ago.
Okay, dry dock. Get to the dry dock. I'm almost there. Gotta get to Paul.
I refuse to leave while Jack's still here. I need to contain him.
Paul, your condition is critical. The stress. If you don't receive your treatment, you know what could happen. Come to the island right now. The treatment will be waiting for you. You will be back in top condition by the time the gale starts.
I don't like it, but you're right. Always looking out for me. Ready to chop.
No. You're not getting away that easy.
I refuse to leave while Jack's still here. I need to contain
him. Paul, your condition is critical. The stress.
We got contact!
If you don't receive your treatment, you know what could happen.
Thank you.
There was something wrong with Paul. Cronon syndrome. He'd had his powers much longer than me. What was the cause? Was I sick as well, or was it his time travel? I didn't know. It didn't make anything he'd done any less hateful.